Hello viewers, welcome to the second e-lecture of The Sound and the Fury. In my previous lecture, I introduced to you the novel The Sound and the Fury, its author William Faulkner, and I briefly talked about the stream of consciousness technique used in the novel. I also spoke about the importance of the novel in the English fiction. In this video, I shall introduce you the main characters of the novel, the division of the novel, and the dates of division. Before I start with the main characters of the novel, I shall give you a brief summary of the novel. The novel deals with the Compson family. The Compsons are the aristocratic southern landowners, but when the novel opens, they are devastated, they are degenerated, because they could not cope with the present time. They could not adjust themselves with the changed scenario. They lost their lands and property in the civil war. So after 1865, slowly they started losing their lands, properties, and when the novel opens, they are completely devastated. They are nowhere, but they are still living in history. They are still dreaming about their ancient. Now, I introduce you the major characters of the novel. Jason Compson III is the cynical and detached father. His wife, Caroline Compson, is the selfish, neurotic mother of the children. Jason Compson and Caroline Compson have 4 children. Quintin Compson is the oldest and oversensitive son who commits suicide on June 2nd, 1910. Then, Cadence Compson, she is also called as Caddy in the novel. She is the only daughter whose promiscuity is one of the central narrative concerns of the novel. Caddy has several affairs and because of which she brings shame to the family. Jason Compson, 4, is the last male Compson and the last child, the 4th child of the Compsons is Benji, Benjamin Compson. Previously, he was called Maury. He is the youngest Compson, but he is mentally retarded. He was born on April 7th, 1895. These are the major characters in the novel. Uncle Maury Boscombe is Mrs. Compson's brother. He is not very important, not as important as these 4-6 characters are. And then there is another important character in the novel called Dilsa Gibson. She is the Negro cook of the family. Dilsa's reference comes towards the end of the novel. In the 4th section of the novel, the writer writes from Dilsa's point of view. So Dilsa Gibson is also an important character. Now we turn to the division of the novel. As you know, novels are generally divided into chapters or into books. For example, Dickens novels are divided into chapters. In such novels, you begin with chapter 1, then you have chapter 2, and so on and so forth. In some novels, the writers divide the novel into books. For example, in Gulliver's Travels, the novel is divided into 4 books. The present novel, The Sound and the Fury, is very different from other novels because it is neither divided into chapters nor is it divided into books. It is divided into 4 sections. The novel has 4 sections. The first is Benji section, then the Quintin section, third is Jason's section, and fourth is narrated on Easter Sunday. It is also called as the author's section. Now, these 4 sections pose problem for many readers. because these sections are not linked to one another. The other novels have chapters or books, and the chapters are closely linked with one another. There is linear connectivity, or there is linear narration in such novels. But in The Sound and the Fury, there is no linear narration. The narration is purposefully broken. The time of the action of the novel is purposefully broken. In a typical story or in a typical novel, one action is linked to another action. There is a cause and effect relation among the scenes or among the actions. This is important because the readers would understand the story easily. In The Sound and the Fury, William Faulkner has purposefully broken the stereotypical narration and the stereotypical time. Therefore, readers get confused while reading the novel. They don't understand what is going on in the novel. The sections deal with different ideas and different thoughts. Each person in each section talks about a very different theme, a very different idea. And therefore, it creates a challenge for the readers. The readers have to be very patient and they should read the novel with full concentration. Otherwise, it is very difficult for them to understand the plot of the novel. And therefore, the novel is considered as a masterpiece of stream of consciousness. In order to have a better understanding of the novel, now I shall give you the dates of narration of the novel. You can take a look at the dates of narration. The first section, the Benji section, is narrated on 7th April 1928. It is the Easter Sunday. The second section, Quintin's section, is narrated on 2nd June 1910. The third section is Jason's section, and it is narrated on 6th April 1928. The fourth section is narrated by the author himself, and it is narrated in the present time. Thus, the first three chapters or sections deal with the memories and ideas of the three Compson children. William Faulkner shows the narration of the three male children of the Compson family. Caddy's narration is purposefully omitted from the novel. Caddy doesn't speak. Caddy doesn't talk about herself or about the family. So you will see that all these sections are recorded on three different days and years. The first section deals with Benji's section. It is the most challenging section of the novel. Benji's section is challenging because Benji is mentally retarded. He is called as the idiot in the family, and therefore whatever he speaks is difficult to understand, is difficult to comprehend. For example, when Benji is at the gate, he remembers something in the past that happened with him at the gate, and he starts speaking about that incident. So the logic is purposefully broken. The chain of narration is broken in Benji's section. Benji is 33 years old, is mentally retarded, and he is considered as the Christ figure in the novel. Look at the date of his narration. It is 7th April 1928. It is Easter Sunday. Easter Sunday is the day on which Jesus Christ was resurrected. He came to life again. And Jesus Christ was also 33 years old when he was crucified. So you can see the analogy between Benji Compson and Jesus Christ. The second section is the Quintin section. Quintin Compson is the eldest son of the Compsons, but he is very oversensitive. He narrates his incidents on 2nd June 1910, the day on which he committed suicide. So his narration
takes place on the very day when he committed suicide. The first two sections are narrated from stream of consciousness technique. That is, readers are unable to make out what is happening in the novel. The narrators move forth and back in their narration. They talk about their memories, about the past a lot. The third section deals with Jason. Jason Compson is the narrator in the third section, and he talks about himself, about his family, and he is the sensible guy in the novel. He is the one who takes care of the family after his father's death. He is the one who looks after his mother. But he is very shrewd and he is very cunning. He steals money from his family and he shows off that he is the protector of the family. The last section, the fourth section, is narrated by William Faulkner himself. And Faulkner narrates the section because he knows that the first three sections don't make much sense. Readers get confused while reading these sections. So in order to make things easier for readers, he himself narrates the section and he explains the Compson family. But the whole focus in the section is on Dilsey. Dilsey is the Negro cook of the family, and the author writes from Dilsey's point of view. So this is how the novel is divided. This is how the novel is structured. In my next video, I shall talk about each section and I shall critically comment on these four sections. Thank you.